mate.
Just unload it, will you? I'm going to back my takings.
Who wants this job, eh?
I don't know, George. All them lonely housewives.
Any fireman, Tosh?
No, nothing.
There you are.
Early days.
You sure these blokes weren't had guns?
Not according to our sources.
Well, everything will be sorted out one these days.
Vehicle in the depot.
Understood.
Rough. Right, just take it easy, okay?
It's them.
Go, go, go! Follow the police!
X-ray heading north on Onslow Road. Attempted robbery, the County Dairies. Two men armed with baseball bats.
Oh, this is just brilliant.
Sarge!
You alright, Adam?
Never better, Sarge.
Seems to me they made a monkey of you, Joe, all of you.
Wasn't that simple, ma'am.
Oh, really? Tell me, what exactly am I missing here, Jim? There you were, forewarned, four of you, plus two vehicles, plus two uniform I had to beg of Inspector Munro.
But we got O'Connell's.
Oh, congratulations.
Rod and Tosh are going through the files now, finding out the known associates. We'll have the other two.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't go making any rash promises if I were you, Joe. Now, what about the getaway car?
On false plates, we're pretty sure. There's a silver Granada stolen locally last night. Chances are it's the same car.
No sightings since the Great Escape?
No.
Right, well, as you say, you've got O'Connell. Put the thumb screws on him. You're going to have to dig yourselves out of this one, people. Excuse me.
Will do.
Steve, what's the score, Ed?
Well, looks like they're going through the back window. Just broke the glass.
She didn't hear anything?
No, it was her daughter that called us. Just popped in on our way to work. Saw the place had been turned over. Old dear was still in bed.
Well, lucky, I suppose. Old girl living alone.
I mean, Judy, that's my daughter, said I should get a dog. But they cost, don't they?
Yeah.
The food, the exercise.
Mrs. Whitfield, PC Quinn and Sandhill Bumblebee team. I'll be investigating your burglary.
Oh, right. Hello.
Okay, leave you to it then, Dave. Cheerio, Mrs. Whitfield.
You going?
PC Quinn is staying. He'll handle things from here.
Oh, right. Yeah. Do you want tea?
Yes, thanks. That'd be nice.
It's just my money that's missing.
All yours, mate.
There's another possible. O'Connell was in prison with him.
Popular chap, isn't he?
What have you got, Tosh?
I'll take your pick, Sarge. Seems like O'Connell's on first name terms with half the villains in Sunhill. Doesn't have a regular crew, just works with whoever, whenever.
Great.
Yeah, that fits with what we know.
Right, we'll get up a list anyway. If we have to, we'll pull them all in.
Right, Sarge. Not happy?
Definitely not.
Nope.
You sure there's no one I can call to come over, Rose? It's just that I don't think I should leave you on your own, that's all.
I'll be fine.
What about next door?
No, I don't want any help from her.
Oh, right.
More tea?
Not for the time being, thanks, Rose. No wedding ring, Rose?
I took it off to wash up.
Well, that's me, then.
Did you get anything?
No prints. I'd say it's the same MO as the Highford Road break-ins.
Yeah, well, lack of one.
Yeah.
All right, cheers. Look, I better love you and leave you then, Rose. Rose?
Sorry. Mars away.
Yeah, I said I'd better be going.
All right.
Look, let me go and have a word with next door, eh? At least tell him what's happened.
Have another cup first.
All right, one more. Then I'm going round, OK?
You know it's in your interest to cooperate.
Really?
Don't worry. We will catch up with the others sooner or later.
Do yourself a favour, Frank.
I mean, it's not as if the job was such a big secret. We knew about it right from the start. Someone's obviously been letting the side down.
I'm saying nothing.
All that I'm saying, Sarge, is we need to protect our informants.
Look, Jim, we were there, waiting. I think Frank O'Connor can probably work out somebody tipped us off.
Yes, but winding him up like that, it's not going to do Jerry Coons any good. Look, O'Connor will move heaven and earth to find out who he is.
Uniform, I found a car, Sarge, dumped just off the Jeffson Way. Sounds like it could be our getaway vehicle.
Right, can you and Rod check that out, Tosh?
Yes, sir.
I want you to speak with Coombs again.
That's not a good idea, Sarge. Look, the last thing that Jerry Coombs needs right now is to be seen with us.
Do you know where to find him?
Yeah, I'd say so.
Right, well, let's get down there, shall we? Throw a bit more taxpayers' money its way. I'll get the okay from the DCI.
Look, no offence, Sarge, but if we are going to see Jerry Coombs, then I prefer to do it alone. It's easier all round.
Don't worry, Jim. I won't cramp your style.
Look, John Morgan can stand up for herself, don't you worry.
Talk about getting egg on your face, though. I mean, the whole lot was down to her. I'll tell you what, I'm going to be sore in the morning. Hello, it's Bumblebee Boy.
Oh, you had a bit of a problem, madam?
Yeah, I got whacked in that milk depot raid, didn't I?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, right fiasco it was. We got one of them, the others had it on their toes. A little bit of help from George here.
You know something? You're very funny, you are.
No other casualties, then?
Only Joe Morgan's pride. You should have been there, Dave. Make a nice change from you, good ruck. Instead of holding hands with all those burglary victims.
A pint of best, please, when you've got a minute.
All right, I'm afraid so.
What a pussy.
That's it, there's another barrel downstairs.
Cheers.
What do you think you're doing? You're going to get me killed, you are. Coming in here like this.
Look, I'm sorry, Jerry.
You're sorry.
Did that job go down?
Yeah. Look, I need to know who the others were.
A couple of O'Connell's lunatic mates.
Give us a minute, will you? Good boy. There were two of them.
Not interested.
Come on, Jerry.
Could have been dozens of people.
That's not good enough. Look, I need a name.
Rob Glennie. It's got to be him. One of O'Connell's mates. Nasty bit of work. They were in here last night, having a few jars, talking business. It's got to be him. I don't know about no others, but it's got to be him.
Have you got an address?
Well, my yellow pages.
I've got a name. Robert Denny. It's a drinking mate of O'Connell's.
Nice one. Right, let's get back, see what we've got on him. Get an address, then it's straight round there.
Blimey.
Yeah, looks a bit second-hand.
Well, you won't get many prints off that, will you?
Battle stations, lads.
Police!
What's going on?
Does Robert Glennie live here?
Rob, no.
Who are you, his girlfriend?
He hates girlfriends.
What is all this?
Still had the price.
We're looking for him in connection with a serious offence.
Where are we going?
Oh, yeah.
Do you know
where he is? Oh, so you found him then, lads?
Yeah. And Lord Lucan.
That'd be very helpful. 35 Chadwell Street. That's just on the road, isn't it? That's all right. Sorry,
Sergeant. Yeah, got the VIN number here, Sarge.
67599.
Last five digits are 67599.
Yeah, confirmed. That is the car believed used in the attempted robbery.
Right, thanks, Sarge.
Great. Now all we need is the driver.
We're looking for Robert Glennie, police.
What's this?
Thanks a lot. All right, lads?
It's our charge.
Right, lads, here we go again. Just hope the Tarag has a go, eh?
Oh, dear, right.
This one now, innit?
Oh, what?
Give it a rest, Adam.
Just say it, Sarge.
Grow up! Robert Glennie?
Nah, I'm quite all right.
What's this for?
It's protection.
What gives you the right coming in like this, eh?
Oh, sorry. Busy, were you?
Hurry.
Where were you on 9 o'clock this morning?
How'd you bring somebody back to a place like this?
Yeah, really.
Oh, I've just found a crown jewels, George.
Is that so?
Oh, what's all this about? Look, I've got no right coming in here. Just found these in a bedroom, Sarge.
I think you've got a lot of explaining to do, Mr. Glenn.
Straight away.
No time like the present. Dave.
Come on, privileged Mr. Glennie.
Well, you might be interested in this. Belongs to Mr. Glennie. We found it in his room.
I told you, it ain't mine.
Blimey.
We're interviewing him on another matter.
Yeah, I'll take a look through it if you like then, Sarge.
Cheers, appreciate it.
Well, this should keep you out of mischief for a while, shouldn't it, Dave?
So you're telling me you were in bed at 10 o'clock this morning?
Yeah, that's right.
With anyone?
No. Has it happened?
10 o'clock's a bit late then, isn't it?
I was out late last night, wasn't I?
Whereabouts exactly?
None of your business.
Tell me, Robert, do you know a man named Frank O'Connell?
I might.
Is he a friend of yours, is he?
Yeah, Frank's a mate, so what?
He was one of the men who raided the depot this morning.
I don't know, you tell me.
Well, we've got him in custody.
Well, that makes me involved too, does it?
Well, let's just say we've reason to think so. Besides, your record speaks for itself, Robert. 2 counts of burglary, 4 for car theft, assault on a juvenile.
She is the clever one, ain't she?
You drove the getaway car this morning, didn't you?
No.
You stole it last night.
You ain't got nothing on me, lady.
We saw you this morning, Robert. Now, come on. Who are the other two?
No comment.
What's this, Dave? Bring and buy sale?
Yeah, I wish. This bloke's been well at it. Already found the property from 3 break-ins.
Nice one.
Yeah, look. What? Do you recognise her? Come on. It's what's her name, isn't it? From this morning.
Oh, yeah.
Rose Whitfield. That must have been hubby.
I thought she said nothing was missing besides the money.
Couldn't have noticed that.
Cheers, Donna. Glennie must have been the driver, Sarge.
We've no real evidence, Jim. Only the word of your Jerry Coombs.
It's written all over him.
What's the latest? Just gonna have another crack at O'Connell, Gov. Let him know we've got his friend Glennie. See if we can rattle his cage. Good luck. Yeah, well, if that doesn't work, we'll start working our way through the list of possibles.
Sounds like it could be a long night. Hope nobody's made any plans. Gov.
Well, it's nice to get a bit of friendly encouragement now and then, isn't it, Sarge?
What do you expect, Jim? Here's Frank O'Connell, please,
Matthew. Yeah, cheers. Thanks a lot.
Ciao. Tosh, are Jim and Joe Morgan around?
Still interviewing, I think.
Well, when you see him, can you tell him that gear from the flat traces back to at least half a dozen burglaries?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. And there's one item I reckon was taken from a break-in last night. The victim didn't report it missing, but I'm just going to pop round there to double check.
Right. I'll let him know. Cheers.
We've had a few developments, Frank. Thought you might want to reconsider your position. We've arrested the man we believe was driving the getaway car this morning.
Really?
Robert Glennie.
Well, well. Fancy that.
He had a few things to tell us. Quite a bit about you and your merry men.
Yeah. I'll bet he did.
We'll have the rest out of him before the day's over.
So what are you telling me for?
I'm just giving you another chance to be sensible, that's all.
Nah. I think I'll leave it to Rob. Talking's what he does best.
Well, it looks like we might have caught your burglar.
Oh, that was quick.
Yeah, we arrested a man earlier this afternoon. We found this in his flat. It is yours, I presume.
Yes. That was my husband.
Did you not notice it was missing?
No. You've caught him then, this man, the burglar.
Yeah, well, we've arrested the man who had the photo. We're pretty sure it's the same person, but we need to make some more inquiries.
Oh, I see.
We're gonna have to hang on to that, I'm afraid, for a while longer, for evidence. Where would he have taken it from? The mantelpiece, sideboard?
No. In my room.
Your bedroom?
Yes.
What is it, Rose?
He said he'd come back and get me.
You saw him?
Yes.
All right, okay, look, just tell me what happened.
I heard a noise. I don't sleep well, see. I just lay there. Then I heard him outside the room.
All right, just take your time.
He came in. I could hear his breathing. I opened my eyes. I had to. I wanted to scream, but I couldn't.
Go on.
He came closer. Right up next to me, I could smell his breath. Alcohol. He wanted to know where my money was. I said, I don't have any apart from what's in the kitchen. He'd already found that. Then he made me take off my ring.
Your wedding ring?
Yes. He said if I told the police, he'd come back and get me. Even if he went to jail, he'd get me when he got out.
You'll be all right now, Rose.
That's what you say.
This is very important, Rose. Could you describe him? Could you see him?
Yes. There's light from outside.
How old?
35, maybe more.
Right.
Have you got my ring?
Yeah, there's a good chance, Rose.
So, you're still not certain about Glennie, then?
No, O'Connell didn't let on either way. We didn't really get much further with him than last time.
Been that sort of day, really, hasn't it, Joe?
Yes, Gov.
Sarge, there's just been a bit of a development.
Yeah, thanks, Dave, Tosh said.
No, I mean, I've just been to see the old lady who was burgled last night. She now says she saw the man. She gave me a description and it fits Robert Glennie to a T.
Right.
Good. Now you've got a stick to beat him with.
Come on, Jim.
Sarge, can I be in on this one? It's just that he threatened her. He shook her up pretty badly. I'd just like to see this one through, that's all.
Yeah, fair enough, Dave. Okay, Jim?
Yeah.
Triffy.
Showing the suspect exhibit BB stroke 2, framed photograph. You seen that picture before, Robert?
No.
Take a closer look. What about the woman in it? Look familiar? I mean, the photo's a few years old now, but even so.
Don't know what you're talking about.
She knows you. She remembers you very well. Every nasty little detail.
You broke into her house last night, didn't you, eh? And a woman, a widow, living alone.
I was in bed last night.
You took her money, but that wasn't good enough, eh? You had to go into her bedroom. Threaten her. We know all about it, Robert. Make you feel good, did it? Seeing how scared she was?
Never threatened no one.
You even took her wedding ring. You're disgusting.
Look, if I was on that milk depot job, I wouldn't have been out in the middle of the night, would I? You answer me that. You say I was out thieving. She says I nicked the getaway car last night. Can't have it both ways.
No, you're right.
You what?
I was wrong. Mistaken. I don't think you were involved this morning, Robert.
How do you mean?
Well, it's not exactly your style, is it? A job like that. Robbery. Violence. Baseball bats. Thousands of pounds. Maybe a bit of opposition.
What are you trying to say? Now listen, lady, I can handle myself just as well as that lot. Better.
I don't think so, Robert. You're not cut out for it.
Old ladies are more your thing.
Even your ex thought you weren't up to it. Is that why she gave you the push, Robert? You weren't man enough for her either.
Listen, I would have been in. I wasn't, but I wanted to be. O'Connell was the one who wouldn't have it.
Really?
Think they're so big. A fine job they made of it, eh? Bunch of idiots. Better off without them.
So you thought you'd go out and turn over a few houses instead?
Who were the other two, Robert? We know you know them. Now come on. You're in enough trouble as it is. I suggest you cooperate. You know Frank O'Connell laughed when we said we'd arrested you? Thought you were a joke. It's not as if you owe them anything, is it?
No. Every man for himself now, isn't it?
Look, the worst thing about this, Tosh, it was my snout who put us onto Glenny in the first place. Don't take it so hard, Jim. She is well out of order.
All right, all right.
I just come in to find you. Glenny's given us the other two on a plate. Emmett Hughes and Kevin Black.
Oh, is that right, Sarge?
I saw those names on the LAO files.
We did get the addresses, Tosh.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, Gov, looks like we've got the other two.
Oh, sorry.
Right, get hold of Rod, will you, and anybody else who's free. We don't want to make any mistakes this time, do we?
Nice one, Dave.
Cheers.
Arrested him for shoplifting down at the Mall, Sarge. He had these on him.
No casualties this time, madam.
Sorry, Sarge.
Doesn't matter.
Finished?
Yeah, for the time being. Should be ready to charge him soon.
Good. Number one.
Put his hand up, has he, Dave?
Not to the milk depot job, no. He wasn't there.
Yeah, that's a choker. Not one of the real villains, then.
I wouldn't say that, Adam.